Hello, welcome all of you. Welcome to beautiful St. Joseph's School here in Petersburg, Virginia. St. Joseph's Catholic School, the oldest Catholic school in the Diocese of Richmond. We're very proud to say it is a great joy to join you once again as we continue our series on St. Joseph's Catholic School. And so I want to welcome all of you. We're going to today focus on one of our buildings here, the main building here at St. Joseph's School. And I have some people to help me with this, and I'll introduce them in a moment. But before we introduce them, I just want to begin with a prayer. So let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Lord, we thank you for bringing us together this day. We thank you for the gift of our faith, the gift of our families, and this wonderful gift of St. Joseph's School to this community, to this city, to this region. We ask, Lord, that you will help us as we present St. Joseph's School so that all those who see this video may grow in a deeper appreciation for the school, but even more importantly, a deeper love for you, who are the source of all good things. And we ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And I want to, again, thank you all for joining us. And remember, when I'm on selfie mode, like right now, what looks like my left hand is really my right hand. And so when I do this, I'm doing this with my left hand, even though I am left-handed, this is really my right hand. And we started with a prayer, and I want to introduce a familiar face, and then maybe a face that some of you are familiar with, but not everybody. So first, I'm going to introduce you to Mr. Ben Uzel. Mr. Ben Uzel, who is, I like to call, our parish historian. Ben, welcome, and thank you for joining us. What can you say a little bit of something about yourself and your relationship?
I graduated from school here in 1975. You can do the math.
75, wow. Yes. Okay. Now, was that 8th grade or was that 12th grade?
That was 12th grade.
All right, okay.
Actually, for me, it was 13th, but I liked 4th grade. I went twice.
Very good.
And I dressed today in what was in our school colors, gold and white.
All right, and, very good.
That was, we had a little black for trim in there, but the official colors were gold and white.
Excellent.
The colors until St. Vincent's, when the two schools merged, and they may have thrown black in there then.
All right. So when you were there, it was St. Joseph's School.
The grade school was St. Joseph's School. The high school was, well, when I started in first grade, the high school was St. Joseph Central High School.
Okay.
And then somewhere in the late 60s, this became Gibbons High School.
All right.
They changed the name because the other parishes that were supporting it thought it was too much under St. Joseph's wing, St. Joseph's Parish, and they said, since we're paying for it too, we want to change the name. So, it was named after Cardinal Gibbons, who was Bishop Gibbons, when the Daughters of Charity came down in 1876 to start running the school.
Very good. Now, but was the grade school from 1876 on always known as St. Joseph's School?
It was always known as St. Joseph's School. In fact, before 1876, in 1873, there are newspaper articles in the city directories that refer to it as St. Joseph's Catholic School.
Very good. Cool. And then also helping us today, we have a wonderful guest, Miss Catherine McElhaney, also known as Miss Mac, and she is the Director of Development at St. Joseph's School. And I'm sorry that the sun is in your eyes, but allows everybody to see you better. So just if you could introduce yourself and say hi to everybody.
Hi, I'm Catherine McElhaney. As Father Redmond said, I'm the Director of Admissions and Development here at St. Joseph. This will be my third school year here, enrolling students in our school that, as Father Redmond said, is the oldest Catholic school in Virginia, and we're still going strong today. And also part of my job is working with all the amazing donors who make Catholic school possible, who donate money so that deserving students from across the Tri-Cities can come here to get a great education rooted in Catholic values.
Wow, and I know firsthand how I've seen Miss Mac working not only with the students, working with donors, working with the parish community. It's just a wonderful resource to our school, and we thank you for all that you do. It's unfortunate Mrs. Owens couldn't join us, the principal. I know she wanted to be here, but she, as you might imagine, you know, actually maybe you don't realize, summertime is actually really busy for the administration at a school. And that, you know, Mrs. Owens is in meeting after meeting after meeting, and I'm sure you are as well. And
yeah, we're especially busy right now. We're getting ready to reopen. St. Joseph will be open 5 days a week in person for all our learners, which is really important that we can do that as a smaller school and do it safely. So we're working on all those plans right now to keep our students and our staff safe and here learning in person and doing what they need to do this year.
You know, it's really cool that we are able, unlike the public schools, which, you know, really cram in a lot of kids into each classroom, St. Joseph School, it's an older school building, and so the classrooms are bigger. And are you, I mean, Ben, back when you were a student here, how many kids were in your, like, in one typical class?
It varied. I'd say probably close to 40.
40, okay, 40 kids.
30 to 40
kids in those classes. And now, Miss Mack, how many, what's our average class size now?
About 12 to 15 students.
12 to 15, and so we're able to, because of this, it's actually like God ordained it to be so that we were able to open up because the kids are able to space out enough in this COVID restriction time. They're actually able to space out in these huge classrooms that used to squeeze 40 kids in. Now we can spread out 12, 15 kids, no problem, right?
Exactly,
it's
yeah.
Pretty awesome, really awesome. Well, let's get out of the heat and then to the AC. Is that all right?
Sounds perfect.
Yeah, so we're out here in front of the main building here. St. Joseph's School, and Miss Mack is going to let us in, and we'll go on in where it's nice and AC. It is really hot out here, and I know for Miss Mack, it's fair complected is probably here. Let me just get a shot of that St. Joseph's School. Very good. Oh, I can feel the AC. Can you all? If you can feel the AC, just give a thumbs up as I'm walking in here.
Father.
Yes, Ben.
Before you get out of the doorway, won't you look at the rug here, St. Joseph's?
Oh yeah, let's look at that.
And if you notice, under it.
Oh, wow. Let me turn it over.
I remember when they changed that, that used to say St. Joseph's. And then when it became Gibbons High, they changed that to Gibbons.
Let me try to swing it around a little bit better so I can get it on here. Wow. Now, were you allowed to lift up that rug like that?
He can tell Mrs. Owens I said it was okay.
Okay, it was okay. All right. Now, I notice there's a little something I'm noticing.
He's trying to get me in trouble. I knew the office very well when I was in school.
Ben, did the stairs used to go down this way?
This used to be the stairs going down to the girls' locker room and restroom.
Okay, because you can see up. Like the design on the tile. Is like, okay, these are going up, but then there's something going on down here, so maybe that used to go down, but it doesn't go down, it now goes up. So they both go up.
Yeah, so we recently renovated it so that we could have the front desk right here, so there's someone sitting here when you walk in to greet you and welcome you to the school.
Well, wonderful. And of course, we have up there our Pope Francis, and Bishop Nestout. As a Catholic school, we always maintain our connections to the diocese and to the worldwide church, the universal church, headed by Pope Francis.
Father, you might find this interesting. When I was in school, they had a portrait of Bishop Gibbons there. And prior to that, when my mother went to school, there was a large mural of the Blessed Virgin.
Oh, right.
And my mother has that mural today.
She has that mural?
Yes.
My goodness. Well, will she donate it back to the school?
We will see. Right now, it's hanging in one of the rooms at home, and she told me about it the other day, and I think she wanted me to know about it because I was doing a tour with you today.
Wow, yeah. I'm sure the school would love to have that someday. Is it beautiful?
It is. It's rather old. It's got like a gold relief frame around it, painted frame.
Wow.
And it's larger than those two together.
Wow. Now, and just so everyone can see, I'm standing right here really because of that AC. Yeah, it's blowing right on me. I love it. All right, so let's keep on going. So this is the entryway. And Miss Mack, what else can you tell us about this room?
Yeah, so we recently renovated this whole office suite thanks to some really generous donors. So this is our administrative office. Mrs. Owens sits back there. Our Dean of Students, Ms. Rhoda, and our business manager, Ms. Vaughn, sit back there. You can also see another portrait of a pretty important guy right there. That's Father Brian, our pastor.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. Father Brian, it looks just like him.
Mm-hmm.
That is an excellent... And now who
is the wonderful artist who painted this?
See, I think it says from Jesus in the corner there.
Wow, that is wonderful. That looks exactly like him. We will make sure he watches this video and sees that he is truly famous. And I love how he is bigger than the Blessed Virgin Mary and Jesus in this. He is the biggest person in this display case. And how appropriate. Although he would surely say, oh, and then we have a pope there as well. Pope John Paul. Is that? No, that's Pope Francis. Or is that? I can't tell who that is. Who is that pope? I don't recognize that pope. I'm sorry. All right. Well, let's maybe somebody in the comments can tell us which pope that was. All right. So let's keep on going.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of looks like John Paul II, but you know, a figurine. It's hard to know who's mm-hmm. who they're trying to depict.
Security here wasn't here when I was in school.
And that, you know, that is an important aspect of this school, right, Ms. Mack? The
yes.
security.
A very secure campus. Very grateful for modern technology that keeps all our students safe.
And you know, there's closed captioned cameras, security cameras. There are these doors that you have to have a fob to get in. We're not going to go through all the security details because we don't want outsiders to know all the ways to get in. But it actually is a very secure building, and that's important nowadays, considering violence that's happened in schools. We are very fortunate to have a very secure mm-hmm. school building here.
Sure.
Okay, so now what's over here?
Right. So this room was renovated just this past few months. It was one of the maybe a silver lining to not having our students in the building is we were able to renovate these two classrooms as well as our middle school classrooms thanks to Mr. Marcus Weinstein, super generous donor who made this possible. So
wow.
This used to be our alumni room. We packed up all that memorabilia so that we can display it throughout the school once the renovations are finished. But this is a brand new classroom. It's going to be our JK through fifth grade religion room.
And wow.
Anyone who hasn't seen this yet, who knows what the old classroom looked like, is going to be super surprised to see it.
Let's look. Yeah, I'm excited about this. Mm. Wow. And it smells brand new. Can you all smell it? Wow. This is amazing.
This was the science lab when I was in school.
This was a science lab.
And they had four tables with the little gas burners and everything.
Uh-huh. And you know, one of the best features about these rooms I just love are these huge windows. Now, these are just they let so much light in. And yet there's those privacy screens as well. And look at the ceiling. Look at these nice brand new ceiling. That's brand new, right?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Now, but they did not turn the AC on in this room, so it is a rather warm room.
We're
so,
conserving energy, Father Redman.
Well, as you should, mm-hmm. as you should. But you also knew I was coming, so you should have. No, I'm just playing. And so you have these wonderful these workbenches here.
Mm-hmm.
And so you said JK through fifth grade religion. Does that mean?
Yeah, so we'll have room for all Miss Castle's activities that she uses for catechesis of the Good Shepherd, all her little work pieces will
yeah.
be here. Lots of space for that.
And I love the hardwood floors. Are these original or are these new floors?
We laid these right over the carpet that was here before.
Very good. Wow. It's a beautiful room. And I bet Miss Castle is very excited about being able to move into here. Mm-hmm. I'm sure she'll put a nice big crucifix somewhere on one of these walls. Is it already there? Oh, wow. It is. I didn't even see it. I was walking right under it. Of course, the American flag. And I'm very excited about having the students be able to use this room. Now, did the students use this room at all last year?
No.
So it was kind of off limits last year. Very good. Well, that's really great. And so there were a lot of alumni kind of trophies and those things will be around.
Yeah, we're hoping to get some shelving up around the school so we can display those things, some kind of choice pieces throughout the school, so they're really more a part of our everyday experience at St. Joseph, because our history is such a rich part of our school tradition.
Absolutely, and I think it's important for
earthquake.
I messed it up here. Hold on, we're not done. We're still here.
You're still on vacation, Father.
All right, here we go. Ah, sorry about that, guys. If you can see me, give me a thumbs up. If you all are there,
Give me a big thumbs up. I'm just having a little issue with, oh good, okay. I'm having a little issue with the tripod. It's kind of rotating a little too easily, and I'm trying to keep that from happening. That's what's going on there. Okay. All right, good. So very good. Back on the tripod. What else can we say? Ben, do you have anything else you want to add about this room?
Well, I had science class here, biology and chemistry.
Uh-huh.
And I was looking at that far radiator over there, and I remember one of the kids brought a snake in, and it got loose, and we couldn't find it for a couple of days. We found it inside the radiator.
Inside the, which one, on the left or on the right?
The one on the right.
Oh, that's funny. So I wonder if the if this snake...
He's not in there anymore.
Are you sure?
This they got him out. Luckily, it wasn't on. The radiator wasn't on. So.
Well, yeah, but you would have had a fried snake at that point.
But right below this room is the old furnace room.
Uh-huh.
And when I started first grade, the coal trucks were still delivering coal to heat the school.
Really?
And there is a, outside the windows in the driveway here, on both sides, on the Lavelle Hall and on the main school building, there are those big doors that you would open up. They'd be about yay big. And there was a slide that went in, and the coal truck would come with a little conveyor, and coal would go right down there.
Now that's cool.
And but, I remember when they dug the hole in the driveway and put the oil tank in one summer, and then they switched to oil.
Okay.
But the coal was still, particularly in Lavelle Hall, there was still a little bit of a coal pile there.
Really?
And one of my classmates when we were in middle school, Henrique Hart, I'll mention him because he got in trouble for it, he said, oh, look at this, and tried to get some of us to go down the slide. He went down it.
He went down the coal slide.
Yes, and we had to wear white shirts back then. Let's say his shirt wasn't quite right, white anymore, oh. And his mother was not very happy when she came to pick
I
him up
bet.
That weekend to school.
That's funny. That's funny. All right, well, let's move out. This room is rather warm, and I'm going to move on out back into... This room has also been renovated. Is
yes.
that
yes.
You wanted to show us that real quick?
Mm-hmm.
I'm
so
loving
this.
This
will be our fifth grade classroom.
Okay, so fifth grade will be in here. Oh, wow.
When I was here, this...
Except for there will be a smart board, just like in that classroom, we'll also have a smart board hung, but...
So a lot of people may not know what a smart board is. Can you tell us?
Yeah, so a smart board is like a smart projector, so you can hook your computer up to it. It projects on the screen. It's a touch screen. You can use it for a lot of different teaching opportunities in that way. We use a lot of technology integration at St. Joseph in addition to smart boards in all our classrooms. We have Chromebooks that all our students use while they're at school, one-to-one Chromebook match. So that's really awesome.
Wow. So, Ben, you were starting to tell us that you remember this room.
This was my eighth grade homeroom classroom.
Wow.
And it was also Sister Cassandra, the teacher then. And she was an old school math teacher. And she had the old blackboards in here, would not let them paint them when they renovated the school in 71. And she was very promotion of fresh air in the classroom.
So the windows were open?
The windows were open. She used to open them at the top with a stick and open them at the bottom.
Uh-huh.
So much that the air could circulate through, because her premise was that fresh air made you think better.
And did it?
And, well, I passed all her classes.
Okay, there you go.
Including calculus in the senior year. And... But she was, she was a particular person. Another thing, if you swing around
uh-huh.
where the little courtyard is here, you'll notice the stained glass windows on the convent.
Yeah.
That's where the sisters had their chapel when they were here.
Very good. And now the chapel is still in use. We will probably show that in a future episode, but that is our daily, well, it was our daily mass chapel. It's such a small chapel, though. We're not sure if we are able to resume daily masses over there because it is, we get 15, you know, I mean, sometimes even up to 20 people at that daily mass. Very hard to socially distance in that little chapel over here. It's a beautiful chapel though, and you can, as Ben said, you can see the stained glass windows, and I just love the this balcony that's up there that they have, that the sisters, I can just imagine the sisters they're hanging out. They didn't smoke cigarettes, I'm sure.
No, but
good. They better not
have. They had air conditioning years ago, so you had a day like this, you had to find a place where it was cool, and that was
get fresh air moving through and such.
Wow.
But think of this classroom. We probably had 40-some people in here, 42 people maybe when I was in eighth grade.
40-some people in this room. Wow.
And Sister Constantia, she was one of those people that used to have a little deck of cards with your name on it, and she'd shuffle it before the class, and then she'd pull the first card up, and that's the person that had to put homework problem number one on the board.
She'd
go down, and when you got to the harder problems, 15 on up on the in the math book, those were sometimes the ones you didn't get, so you're hoping you got called for one of the earlier ones. And what we would say was, and Sister was from up north, and she did not appreciate the southern dialect.
Oh.
And when someone would say, "Sister, I didn't get that one," it's not get, it's get. Then everyone say, get, and she would just go like this and cringe.
That's funny.
And you know, you have to appreciate those days back then, when students acted like that, I guess. But she was probably one of the best math teachers I've ever had. And I know that UVA called up the school here when it was Givens High School, wanting to know what method of math that was being taught here, because the students from here were always well prepared.
That's great to hear.
They were shocked to find it was the old-fashioned math classes.
Uh-huh. That's great. So now, is Sister still living, or did she pass away?
She passed away several years ago. My aunt, who was a daughter of charity that was down in Bolivia, was she had come back from Bolivia to Emmitsburg, and when I went to pick her up to visit family, I went to see some of the old sisters, and Sister Constantia was still alive.
Oh, okay.
And she was in the nursing home part of the Emmitsburg.
Up in Emmitsburg.
And she remembered me.
Oh,
which I assume, I'm hoping was good.
Uh-oh.
And,
she
didn't know who my brother was, but I know who you are. and then after that, and she sent me a little thank you card for visiting her, and then about 6 months later passed away.
Wow.
So I was looking for her grave at Emmitsburg last time I was up there. Next time I go, I'll try to find her.
I love these wonderful stories of St. Joseph's School, and you can just imagine, this school was founded in 1876. And how many generations of these stories that people could tell? I'm sure some of the people listening, in fact, some of the people who are listening, Millie Youngblood Horner says she taught here for several years. Didn't she teach art? And then we have Betsy Dane, who is school here. She was in the last class to receive of Central High, and then received her diploma from the first graduating class of Gibbons High School. Isn't that neat?
Mm-hmm.
That's so cool. And just, I'm sure there's others who are here, who are listening in. And so if you have stories to tell, tell us the stories. I'm sure we'd love to hear them live, or as you watch later on, write them in the comments. All right, well, let's keep on moving. Where should we go next?
For sure, maybe the auditorium.
While we're heading to the auditorium, maybe I can inject in a little history, Father.
Please do.
This building was actually, the groundbreaking for this building was done on July 1st of 1916.
Uh-huh.
And they were expecting to have the building finished by Christmas, but it wasn't until April that the school was able to move here.
It's a little warm. If you all can feel the, whoa. If you all can feel how warm it is in this auditorium, give me a thumbs up or something.
Well,
how about that? No, 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 don't do that, because that looks bad.
The school actually moved here in 1917. So we were starting World War
this way, and then
Father Bishop O'Connell came here for the dedication of the school, and actually did a special high mass here in the auditorium.
Did he really? Wow.
And so that was in April of 1917. Well, one thing to keep in mind is that Camp Lee over here did not have all the facilities it needed. This auditorium and the gymnasium below us were two of the more modern type of gyms and auditoriums in the city.
Wow.
And so some of the troops were coming over here, you know, for dances or for to use the gym and such.
And that's something. I had no idea. Wouldn't it be neat if we could find some pictures of that,
mm-hmm.
from those that the around World War I era
troops coming into this auditorium for a formal dance or I don't know what they did back then. But
I've got a couple figures here you might find interesting. In 1910, the old school that was over on Market Street had 5 teachers and 114 students. Well, by 1929, the school here had 9 teachers and 262 students.
Wow.
So it really increased by having this facility. Mm-hmm. Another thing to keep in mind, this school building was one of the most modern in the country at the time.
Really?
And Petersburg was, they had this dilapidated building over on Union Street and across from City Hall, and that prompted the city to build what is now the Governor's School.
Oh, okay.
And it also prompted the city to build the armory, which used to sit where the library sits today.
Very good.
And that is where this school ended up playing its games for a number of years.
Would be over.
And I remember my cousin playing there, and you might ask the folks if they remember the toucan that used to sit out in front of the armory when we used to play.
If you remember that armory, give a big, those cannons, give a thumbs up. And I love these big windows. Again, we are so blessed. You know, these big, you know, almost floor-to-ceiling windows. And, of course, it's such a big, tall room. They're really enormous windows, and they give a lot of sunlight and just wonderful views of the neighborhood around us here near Center Hill Mansion. Now, Ms. Mack, any other thing you want to add? What do you currently use this room for?
Yeah, so we just did some updates in here. We got these beautiful new chairs thanks to some of our friends. If you remember, I used to give tours to alumni, and we had these orange metal chairs, and people would say, wow, this is about the only thing that hasn't changed in this building. So if you remember the orange metal chairs, give a thumbs up. We finally were able to get some new chairs in here, which our children say are much more comfortable now.
Oh, I bet.
We painted just this year, so you can see the sconces are painted gold. The gray and blue paint looks so great.
And we had wonderful painters who mm-hmm. volunteered those services.
Yes, really wonderful. Our current family at our school donated their time and their labor for us. So this is where we have our school mass. This is where we have our assemblies, like our talent show, our Christmas program. We do our Peacemaker program in here, which I know is a favorite of our school community, to recognize our students who go above and beyond in living their Catholic values. So just a gathering space for our community.
I love it. And you know, I know I've celebrated mass here as well during the winter months when the kids. Now, Ben and I have talked about this. When it was too cold to walk, Ben, did you all still walk over to the St. Joseph's?
We did in grade school. The sister would keep an eye on us that we all stayed together and didn't wander anywhere.
Yes.
And we were told, stay together as a group, walk in. You had to walk in double file when you walked in. It was very militaristic back then in a sense, because we were forced to get in line by alphabet or by height.
Okay.
Depending on the teacher's preference. And when they would take attendance sometimes in the playground without it in school, you had to get in line by grade, and you know, it was stuff you don't do today.
Well, they've gone easy on them, and maybe in the winter time they don't do the march across town over to St. Joseph's School. They celebrate Mass here, and it is a beautiful place to celebrate Mass as well. But that old school part of me wants to say they should be walking across the town uphill both ways in 3 feet of snow, but I guess
I got dropped off in the morning about over on Bolingbroke Street about quarter after seven in the morning.
Uh-huh.
I had to walk to school, wait in the playground until the school opened.
Wow.
And then you go.
Okay.
I don't let the cold out.
Oh, I see. Now, of course, they're still in summer mode. They're still in summer mode here, so we see some desks and items out here in the hallway.
Yeah, so here's what one of our kind of more finished classrooms. You can see the furniture. We're spreading out. We're testing out some different, social distancing in here. So we had a meeting in here this afternoon. That's why it's a little messy, but this is our third grade classroom.
Very good, yeah. And then let's show
the senior homeroom classroom. Sister Celeste, who we called Sarge,
uh-oh,
was the teacher there.
And then
she was proud of her name. And there was 32 of us in the classroom in there, and we still had a little extra room.
And then this room.
Yeah, we set this up as our teacher work room this year. So for any of our classes anymore to really be functional. So we put the teacher space in here.
Yeah, this mm-hmm. and this works well for that. Mm-hmm. Now, why is there a door over there? Where does that door lead?
That is a fire escape.
Are we?
Yeah, sure.
Let's check it out.
The fire escape was put in the summer of 71.
Oh, really?
Yes, between 8th grade and 9th grade year. And the same thing with the one on LaBelle Hall. And there used to be a connection between the auditorium. And there was a little overpass, a covered overpass there.
Really?
That you would go across. So if you had classes over there in the raining, you didn't have to go.
Was
it? One time the dumpster used to be in the playground.
Uh-huh.
And the dumpster truck loaded the dumpster up on the dumpster. And then he couldn't get out because that was there.
Oh.
And it took him a while to figure out how to lower the dumpster without dumping it in the playground.
Very cool. Now, what are these things here?
Oh, it's like to cut out letters. You put them through the punch. See, the punch out letters.
Oh,
and different shapes and things. This one's an exclamation point in parentheses.
Huh.
You know, to make bulletin boards like
wow.
teachers do.
Very good. And then we have.
This is my office, but I heard that this was the principal's office at one time. So I'm kind of lucky. I got the office with a nice view.
Yeah, you can sort of see like how this could be kind of the brains of the operation. It's like at the top center of the building,
mm-hmm.
you know, literally the brains, and you have control over everything, right?
But then if you were in trouble, you had to sit out here in the hallway where everybody could see you.
Oh,
so
yeah.
So now Mrs. Owens has a little bit more privacy if she's in her family.
Very good. And then let's look at this one room here. No, this looks like a fun room. What is this?
This is another resource room. So all our guided reading and guided math materials are in here. These are all the different leveled books. One way that we do differentiated instruction is through guided reading, making sure that we're teaching to each individual student and not just to the class.
Is that another fire escape door?
No, this goes to the, this is an adjoining classroom.
That was a fire escape door. So you can get the fire escape over here.
Gotcha, okay.
This room was the French room when I was in school.
Oh.
And our French teacher when I was in 10th and 11th grade was Mrs. Spagnol.
That doesn't sound very French.
She was from China.
Oh.
So we learned French with a Chinese accent.
Oh, muy bien.
And we used to sit on those windowsills and throw stuff down at people.
Uh-oh. Man, you should not be admitting to that. Hold on. I'm trying to get through this stuff here.
This was the 10th grade homeroom, and this was the Miss Swagger had this room.
Okay.
She taught theology and history.
So now what is this room, Ms. Mack?
This is our 4th grade classroom.
Uh-huh.
Yep, so you can see kind of the same elements in here. That's what a smart board looks like we were talking about.
Oh, yeah. So this is covered up, of course, but
mm-hmm.
there's a projector that kind of projects down this way, and then it's a touch board, too, and you can actually draw on it as if it were a whiteboard, but an erase, but then also have a computer... you know, elements on there, you know, different things that may be projected from the computer. And what is that?
Exactly. This goes to auditorium.
Oh.
This room used to be the change in staging room for plays when we used to put plays on.
Oh, right.
In addition to being a classroom.
That's kind of cool. I love secret passages. That's what this is. Whoa. And you feel how hot it is. This is a secret passage to the auditorium. How cool is that? Very good. Very good. All right, well, let's keep on moving. We want to finish it, wrap this up pretty quickly here. I know I'm kind of hungry.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so what else is there to see? Is there, we want to see the gym?
In the gym?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ms. Mack. She's such a great tour guide.
Yeah, it's like it's my job or something. I don't know.
So, Ms. Mackey, earlier today you said you were doing a tour for some prospective students.
Yeah, I had three tours today, actually.
Three?
Yeah. So, lots of families coming to check out what Catholic education has to offer, especially right now, considering you know, the situation with the pandemic. See if this is the right fit for their family. So if you are sitting at home and interested in scheduling a tour, I'm happy to do that. If you go to our website, you can schedule a tour online. It's super easy, or feel free to give us a call here.
Awesome. Very good. So now we're going down a level to the gymnasium.
Split systems in all our classrooms, so that's it works awesome. Very well.
Very good. And this is a great gym. Now, Ben, do you remember any big games here?
Well, the girls played, and I remember it's not standard size for gym today, but years ago it was. My mother said they played their home games here, and she played on the varsity girls team.
Wow.
But back then, they didn't do all the running and everything they do today. It was basically a half-court game, is what she said. And he passed the ball a couple of times and then shot at the basket.
Very good.
But I can remember gym class in here when I was in grade school. And the gym teacher, Coach Hudson, who also coached the high school basketball team, if he got mad at us, he would make us line up on the wall and count the bricks. And that was our punishment. And he says, and I know how many bricks there are here. But this is where we had our basketball practice for both the varsity and the JV team. At the time, there were plywood backboards on either end. And then we had a glass one that we got later. So, because some of the high school.
And there was probably a scoreboard somewhere at one point.
Never was a scoreboard in
here. Oh, there wasn't. Okay.
When I was here. But I can remember standing right here when I was in third grade, frozen, because I had got sent to the office for writing on my arm with a ballpoint pen.
Oh, Ben, you're a troublemaker.
She was mad, furious, and she sent me to the office, and I stopped about right there and froze because I didn't want to, you know, have to see Sister Vincent.
Oh, I bet.
And
I
Sister
bet.
Vincent, well, let's just say that she, everybody was afraid of her, had a very fearful respect of her. And one of the other sisters from high school was coming in, and what are you doing here? I said, I want to see Sister Vincent. She says, oh, up the stairs and to the right. So I went up there, and Sister Vincent says, what do you want? And I said, Sister said that for me to come up here because I did this. Well, go wash it off and go back to class. So I went back, did it, and went back to class. And Sister Ann Carolyn was, I think, a little miffed that I didn't get punished. You know?
Well, you know, Ben, I agree with her because I think you should have been punished.
Probably so.
Yeah. Now, John Murphy is here, and he says, Ben, tell Father how many bricks make up the walls.
I can't remember, but John, you're free to come one day and count them again.
That's funny.
Tell John I said hi.
Well, you can tell him hi. He's listening.
John and I were in class together from fourth grade to senior year.
Wow. All right. So one of your oldest
John,
friends.
John, if you don't tell any stories on me, I won't tell any on you.
Uh-oh. All right. Well, I think we're going to need to wrap it up. Is there anything else you want to tell us, Ms. Mack?
No, I just I grabbed our basketball trophy. This is from our third and fourth grade girls team this year, came in second for their division.
Really?
So I want to give a shout out to them just that, you know, in recent years, we've really done a lot with our athletics program, thanks to Coach Rowe. This year, a lot of excitement and just kind of another aspect we're adding to our school community.
And can you give us a little update on Coach Rowe? I know so many people in our parish community were praying for Coach Rowe. He had that medical, truly an emergency back in January where,
yeah.
I mean, he was pretty much, a lot of people thought he wasn't going to make it, and he really did well.
Yeah, Coach Rowe was doing really well. He was, we did our kind of socially distant last day of school parade, and he was able to come to it and sit outside and wave to our kids. It was great to see him. He's doing really well, and we're still, you know, praying for him as
a
he's
full
got some recovery, ahead,
yeah.
But we are so happy and just grateful to still have him in our lives.
Yeah, so pray for Coach Rowe for a full recovery, and wouldn't it be great if he could be back in here coaching again, like, you know, and he coached all those basketball teams, and he just did a great job with the kids. I saw him as he was teaching the gym class. He's a great young man, really a role model for so many of our students.
Absolutely.
So, well, why don't we close out with a prayer? I'm going to swing the camera back to me. And I'll take this mask off when I lead us in a prayer. And I want to, first, before anything else, I just want to thank you for joining us for this tour of St. Joseph's Catholic School, this part two of the tour.
We have more to show you. This was just kind of the main building here in the middle. But then we also have Lavelle Hall, which is a beautiful building, worthy of its own episode. It's a really wonderful place. And then, of course, we have the primary wing, which is also really cool. A lot of new renovations going on there as well. And we might be able to squeeze the convent in as well when we go over there. And then I think Ben, in one of those episodes, is going to kind of talk to us a little bit about the neighborhood that we're in. This Rich is a very historic neighborhood, and last time he gave us a little bit of a teaser on that with some presidents who have visited here.
Wow.
Some pretty cool stuff. So why don't we close with a prayer, and I hope to see you sometime, hopefully maybe by the end of the week we might be able to do another episode. I've got to talk to these guys and see what we can do. So let's close with a prayer. In the name of Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, thank you so much for bringing us together this evening. We thank you so much for the gift of Miss Mack and her ministry here at St. Joseph's School, for Ben, for his wonderful historical knowledge, and of course his experiences here, his stories. We thank you for all the many graduates and students who've gone through these hallowed doors, these hallowed halls. Please bless all of them, all of us, this entire community. And together we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, God bless you all. Thank you for joining us. Be on the lookout. I'm not sure yet which day we'll do it, but I'm running out of time. I leave here August 11th, but I'm not here at all next week, pretty much Monday through Thursday or Friday. So we're going to have to squeeze in a couple episodes, I don't know, out of thin air. We'll figure out. Good to see you all, and God bless you. Stay cool. It's very hot out there. I'm sweating. So, all right. God bless you. Bye-bye.